I've worked with Correct Toes pretty much ever since I came down to Portland, so almost 3 years. They're most directly beneficial for people who have injuries towards the front of the foot, the back of the foot, and kind of up the leg, whether they have neuromas, bunions, hammer toes. I always go with Correct Toes 100% of the time. Hind foot stuff, whether it's like plantar fascial stuff, tibialis posterior, peroneal tendinopathies, even some ankle instability things, I go with Correct Toes almost all the time, depending on what somebody's foot posture and what they're coming in with. If somebody is kind of has different issues up the train, let's say they have knee or hip symptoms, but I can see from their foot posture that it's a very likely contributing factor because they don't have a chance to stabilize from the bottom of their foot. That's also kind of a go-to. So I guess the closer to where the Correct Toes are, the more directly I'm sure that I'm making a change, and then kind of like funneling up the chain from there based on how much it looks like their foundation needs some help. I really let people, let my patients sort of dictate in a lot of ways, or their bodies dictate what the treatment should be like in terms of the volume. I'll introduce it to them, let them know what it does for them, show how it's going to help them, and then just like in the packet says in the booklet, you know, half hour is a good earmark, but really I let people's bodies know. They should never be uncomfortable, they should never be sore when they're wearing them. And if they are, I tell them to take them off. And that's kind of the progression that I have people do, knowing that we're trying to spend as much time as possible as their body can tolerate in a natural foot position. So I'll put them on in clinic, let them get a feel for it. And for some people that might be 5 minutes the first day, for others that might be 3 hours or even more. So I let their bodies kind of dictate as we're kind of building up their tolerance to kind of a natural foot position. And they have that 30-day window where if things don't work out, they can send them back. And by that time, almost all the patients that I work with are really like how they feel on their feet, and they are wearing them at hours per day and kind of seeing the benefit for it. So if they're listening to their bodies, they kind of dictate the amount of use. And I just kind of introduce it, I guess, and help make any changes that are needed if they're having issues in the meantime. First of all, it's people who, because of where they're coming from or the business nature that they're in, they don't feel that they can wear a shoe with a wide enough toe box that can kind of support their natural foot position, which includes having Correct Toes in there. And so their adherence might be very limited. There's also groups of people who have, because of their foot deformation or the length of their toes, they don't really quite fit on there because everybody's foot is created differently. And we can usually help them with edits and modifications to the Correct Toes themselves. And then there's some people who just want to wear them sort of at night, or they just don't feel right on their feet. They can't quite wrap their mind around it. They kind of bug their feet. And so sometimes we can do socks or something like that. But some people just don't want something on their toes. They just feel kind of uncomfortable with it, and their body's telling them otherwise. And if we've done our modifications and they're not asking for it, well, that's their body telling to them, and that's what I listen to.